Oh, Jesus.
What that is this? That rum's touching me still.
God damn, girl.
Crazy. What day is it today?
Thursday, Tuesday. The 1st of October.
Oh, it's
come on,
oh,
first
sorry.
Of the month and that.
Pinch punch. First of the month and all that
pinch
good
punch
stuff.
For, yeah, pinch yeah. punch the person that's next
don't
to you.
Don't touch
that.
Me.
Pass it on, innit? Are we back, bitches?
Yes.
Come on. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. If you're listening for the first time, my name is Fols, whatever.
Mr. Vans in the building.
We got Almighty Saucer in the cut.
Oi, oi.
We got Chrissy in the wings texting away. Who's texting us? Who's texting us?
Texting.
Ooh, preying. Explore page. And we got Essie in the building.
Hair.
AKA Champagne Essie.
Hey.
AKA Amazing Eyebrows Essie. AKA Water Wave.
Wait. No, that was.
We don't do Water Wave anymore.
No, I need to replace the closer on that wig.
Okay, cool. We retired Waterway for now.
Birthday Essie.
Birthday
yeah.
Essie. CEO Essie and that.
Yeah.
Head Sanctuary. Culture of Sanctuary London and that.
Yeah.
You know.
Big you up, Norma.
Thank you.
Yeah,
thank
man.
You, thank you.
I think a good place to start. Last week, some of the RNA listeners were probably upset at us that we didn't do a Potter Payper review, innit?
Yeah.
And I was a little bit upset when we finished. But I was like, you know what? Actually, I've got the perfect person for the job.
Ding, 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 ding.
You don't even have to apply. No CV. You got the job.
Jeez.
You got the job.
I love it.
You're in.
So Essie's here, and I think that's a good place to start. Potter Payper released the third installment of his trilogy, Training Day. I don't know if you're going to get another one, but Training Day 3, TD 3. And before we get into all of that, you were part of the pop-up shop.
Yeah.
Invasion, yes. Meet and greet.
Yes,
and
yes.
I'll let you, as much as I love the sound of my own voice, I'll let you do the explaining. Don't laugh too much.
Okay,
I laugh is a bit too much.
All right.
I'll let you do the explaining of what that all entailed and the work you did with Potter for the album.
Yeah, so we did, or Sanctuary London, we did the experiential side of things. So we did the pop-up shop. So it was a two-day event in Chelsea. And obviously, initially, it was supposed to be an exhibition in a venue in London Bridge. So there's a big, big, massive space. And there was like the floors and the walls all had screens on them. So you would walk in, it was like immersive, like sound. Do you get it? It was going to be lit, but it was big. And we were going to like bring a car in. And obviously, if you look at the album or the EP artwork, there's like a beat up car. And then there's like the buildings that are like burnt out. So we're going to have all of that.
Derelict buildings,
exactly. We're going to have all of that in the space. But then Boris was like, yeah, rule of six. So the space was massive, a big, big warehouse. Yeah, so it just wouldn't work with six people. So obviously we were chatting to the venue and whatever. And this was like the day Boris announced it. We were like, yeah, we can't do it. It's fucked. It just wouldn't make sense. Obviously not knowing that.
What was the place? Stiltyard?
No, Aures, called Aures.
Okay.
Well, I may pronounce it wrong. A-U-R-E-S. But obviously not knowing that the rule of six doesn't really apply to much. I mean, I don't know what it applies to, but it doesn't apply to what we were doing, innit?
Right.
So we could have done the event still. People just had to be in groups of six, not six people in.
Okay.
Do you get it? But yeah, we didn't know this at the time. So we locked that event off. And then literally on the Friday, the week before, we got a space. It was like a shop unit. And then when we went to meet the woman, she was like, yeah, you can have more than six people in here. And I was like, well, we could have just kept our original idea. But anyway, I think this worked out better because smaller space, could obviously dress it better. So we had like a mover corner, obviously Mover's in jail. And Potter and Mover are very, very close. So we had like a letterbox, we had like a Dear Mover section, you could post your letters to Mover, we did like a photo wall, and then we had a green screen, we had a photo booth, and then we just had like little touches, like an oven with Pyrex on it, and like chains, money, cassette tapes, like Zancos and like trap phones, and just stuff around the unit. So
drug paraphernalia.
You know, well,
allegedly,
exactly. But yeah, it was lit. It was good. And Potter was amazing. Like, obviously, he was like, no one's ever done this for me before. I've never been to anything like this. And his fans came from like Cardiff, from like Bolton. Like, they were traveling to meet him. And people was like, I was writing to you when he was in jail. And he's like, yeah, I remember you. Like, he's so cool. And he stayed for a time. And obviously, we had security. So we had five security for the 2 days. But he was just in and out. He was on the road. He was coming back in, chatting to people. Like, it was nice. It was really, really nice. So
yeah, it looked like a safe environment.
Yeah, it was.
You know, Chelsea.
You lot was out of the ends. As I was walking up, people was looking at me like, why am I here? And as I got closer, they clocked I was going to the nigger scene.
No, to be honest, his fan base, I'd say, obviously, it wasn't like, oh, this hella man them, like, this event. He had girls traveling, he has a lot of women who are his fans. He had like the lads come in, like tradesmen, people came off the work. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, his fan base was very eclectic. He had school kids, he had children come in. One boy came after school. Like, he's got a serious fan base. And this is the thing with rappers, like, especially his type of rap, maybe not so much the new school, but if you can sell your physical CDs, you can sell your merch, then you should do it. Because not everyone can do that.
Oh yeah, for sure, man. Like, I think
do you get it?
A lot of artists
can't
underestimate the fact that, you know, that is a possibility as well.
But it takes work, and also you've got me putting the groundwork in for a minute.
Yeah.
Work in terms of like actually doing stuff like that. So a lot of people might not know, and I hope we can get into it as well, the work that SC does with Sanctuary London.
Mm-hmm.
What is actually on offer if you speak to the right people, what they can bring to life. And then actually like consistently feeding your core fan base with a solid amount of material, staying consistent. We're in this era of like, we like big commercial songs, don't get it twisted. We've been raves turning up on that. But if the artists that you like when they stay true to themselves.
But the thing
and
is,
he's someone that has done that.
Yeah, and even in terms of consistency, like his type of rapper, they don't even need consistency.
Mm.
They don't need that at all. And they don't need to really feed their fans because their fans are with them regardless. Do you get it? Someone like Nines could not release a tape for 3 years. Scraps could not do that for 3 years. Potter couldn't. Blade does not need to release a song ever again.
Blade has big gaps. He has massive gaps.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Gaps,
but
and then when they drop, in like all the
creates a moment.
Exactly. Yeah, like just stream my shit and people
and
stream it.
And that's it. Exactly. Yeah.
And the next thing that you'll see is them announcing a live show.
Yeah.
But having a pop up shop, I think it's so dope. Like if I'm a fan of an artist,
you
want
to go and see
like,
them.
You want like because
I saw
it's,
people
it's
there
buying.
See the people that I know can go on Spotify and stream all the projects bought. Trained their 1, 2, and 3 physicals, got them
and
signed,
move
got
exit their wounds.
Bought Mover Exit Wounds, got their poster signed, bought merch, spent money.
But not like I said, there's. I think it stops. Personally, it probably stops at maybe Fredo could
what do
a physical, as in like that kind of rapper who could do a physical.
No, it'll I think Rimzy.
Yeah, Tiny Boots.
And I like the fact
right,
someone like
right.
Potter Payper's come back because I feel like
right.
for him to be successful, we need. A few more, so
no, but Fredo's the newest, as in
Fredo's newest, but like he still kind of leans into the newer school
so
with
that's
like,
I feel like
drippy. He will take
it.
A risk and do Hickory Dickory Dock. We ain't got to do the argument that we had during lockdown, but like
I like that's like, personally.
Like you know the RNA,
yeah,
Real Nigger Alliance,
yeah,
the soundtrack to their life,
yeah,
there's a certain type of artist. So exactly. I don't remember when Kenny All-Star was still on Radar Radio, he had a freestyle with some guy called Bam Bam.
Okay. Yes, tall, I do. Light skin, yeah.
There's
yeah.
that type of real nigga
yeah,
rap.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
In this
yeah,
era
yeah.
of Afro yeah. swing, Afro beats,
yeah.
whatever
yeah.
the rain and sound, drill, whatever
something
the rain
like
and sound is.
G could do something like that.
You have to strip it back, but it has to be a lot of artists. So, like, if Tiny Boots can't be over there doing it by himself, he's got to be doing music. You've got hair from Potter Payper. You've got hair from Rimzy. I liked hair from Bam Bam. You've then got hair from a new up-and-coming guy and whatever ends is the ends. And
but the thing is, you say Backroad G because of sound, but you have to remember his fans grew up with streaming. His fans probably never owned a CD player.
No, she's right.
Do you get
right,
it?
Right.
So I don't even think he can... As much as I think he's hard, I'd say Stormzy, obviously, by the sheer volume of fans he has.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm like, Stormzy
he's doing shops.
Numbers. Exactly.
them man are doing pop-up
do
shops
get
in
it?
Shops.
But... That's why I said I think Fredo's the last.
I know what you're referring to. There's certain type of artists where people will come out of their house because people
they
don't
want your
people,
CD.
Those type of artists, people don't mind saying out loud they're a fan. I have people in the queue. Like, you know, there's that kind of like stush energy of Londoners sometimes. And I don't know where all the people were from in the queue, so I'll just say that. But people generally were speaking.
From Bolton.
No, like, we're just all in the queue, man, are saying, oh, what was your favorite song? What was your favorite
lit.
Song off the
it's
tape?
Lit.
How long have you listened to Potter?
It's lit.
Like, we was having that kind of conversation. Even the some of the bouncers, isn't it?
Yeah.
I don't know where the guy was from, but he was talking to another guy behind me, innit? And he was talking about Potter and when they
it
first
was
started
just
listening
such a good
to him.
Event.
So I think
good.
That's dope. I want to see him stay home so we can actually see if he has a clean run, what it looks like. Because, like you said, someone like him doesn't need consistency, but I think part of the reason why I accept it is because he had so many jail stints. If he stays home for 4 to 5 years now, let's now see where he can take this thing to.
Yeah.
Now he's on the charts, so...
Number three, baby!
Yeah, I mean, he's in a position that he's never been in before.
Yeah.
So I think that's more of an incentive to kind of clean up his act or get his act together and strictly stay on that path.
But at a certain age, after so many offences, someone like him, you get one more, you're done.
Yeah.
You're not in the like... Do one more, you're finished, bro.
Well, yeah, so hopefully he takes all of that on board.
Like I said,
he's in a position now that he's never been in before.
Yeah.
So that's hopefully going to open up different doors for him
100%,
and open his eyes and see, like, right, you can actually leave that other side behind.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying? Like, it's when everything is now legit, And you've now got to see that people are coming to a shop.
And he's up and down the country as well.
Bro, like, yeah, come
yeah,
on,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, but the other ones, he literally just pulled up and everyone just came out. So it was lit. So even stuff like that, it didn't have to be a shop. You could have just said, I'm touring, I'm doing a UK tour with CDs in my boot, come and check me. And that's what's going to... Honestly, you might not think, selling a CD is going to do anything, but it's just worth so much more. Do you know what I mean?
So I rang my bro in the day. I got him a signed CD. He's like, bro, yeah, please get me one.
It's worth so much more, honestly. So, yeah.
So how do we feel about the album? Training Day 3.
It's an EP.
It's on streaming sites. So I don't
get it's not an album, though. It's not an album. But, come on, it's like 24 songs. It's not an album.
It's 24 songs.
It's bare songs
album.
On
that's an album.
No, it's not. It's not. It's not. It's not. Even the way it sounds and the way it feels, it's definitely not an album. Like, people are comparing
There's a lot of samples as well.
Do you know what? I won't even argue because it is part of Trillion. Training Day this year was a mixtape in itself.
Yeah, and obviously people
We don't argue with Essie on this podcast. RNA.
Cufflinks. Cufflinks. People are comparing it to Crabs in a Bucket, which I understand why you would do that. We can't. Because Crabs in a Bucket is an album. It's polished. It gets a certain job
Production's
done.
Cleaner.
Yeah.
I don't think it's that much more polished than... Like, Potter Payper doesn't sound it was done in polished. A movie studio.
No, it doesn't. But it's just like, it's refined. Whereas Training Day 3, like, you're sitting with this for a long drive. Like, the sample, some songs are 6 minutes long. Like, it's definitely a tape. It's not an album, do you get it? But I think
it's definitely
brilliant.
Coming out on the M-way.
No, it's brilliant. It's so good. The quality.
What are your standout songs?
Well.
Quite a few for me.
Green District.
When I Was Little, for me.
Okay. Slumdog Millionaire, obviously the Snow sample.
Come on.
Yeah.
And then, obviously, With Me, because you know I like my girl tunes. And then I like...
Midnight on Ilford Lane.
I like Purpose. Midnight on Ilford Lane. Bluetooth. But let me drop the chat list.
But King's Blood.
King's Blood, and I'm next in the line of succession. Yeah. I'm listening to it just now.
What's the tune where it says...
Bando Embassy, Prevention and Cure.
Keys like Ice City, Keys like Morgan. He's got some lines on there.
Memoirs. Like, it's just hard. It's just 24 songs. Bando Embassy. For me, it's Prevention and Cure.
I did a mean session in the gym to this mixtape.
The tricep dips. Are you not seeing me? Wait, are you not seeing me?
Please.
I'm slowly getting back. The bed is going down, you know.
Julie.
Hey, don't get twisted, you know. Bro, Corona is coming off, yeah? Yeah, listen, look at the triceps.
It's brilliant.
No, the mixtape's hard.
It's so good.
The mixtape's hard.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I enjoy it, man. Like, and it's a nice mesh between the kind of beats that he picks and the subject matter of the music.
Definitely.
Alongside, in how he raps.
Mm.
It's raw. It's still raw and
it's
gritty.
Hard.
Like,
it's hard.
And, you know,
No filter.
It just makes
no
sense.
No rice filter. Nothing.
Beggars and
chooses. Like, there's a lot of
beggars and
chooses. There's honesty in the music as well about.
But that's what we really want, because like everybody, I want to hear about your L's. I want to hear everything.
Yeah.
Like, I want a totality of you. I don't like at me. I can go Hakkasan too on it. Me too. I can go Sexy Fish. Bob Ricard, Press for Champagne.
Ooh. I heard that.
You know,
I'm going on Friday.
I too can go there.
Oh, yeah. What? Date settings?
Nah. Well, hold on. Yeah, I'm going on Friday, but I need to put it in my diary.
We'll get into that after. Just
glossed over the date settings.
Yeah. No, there's a date. I'm meeting Nike.
That's right. Throw Nike in there.
Hey, Nike.
Hey, girl.
Oh, my mum said hi, by the way.
Mum said hi?
Yeah.
They said, what up?
Big up, mumsy. What up? And that.
But
big
yeah, no, it's excellent. This is the type of rap I like.
Yeah,
do you get it? And I think everyone can say that it's the type of rap that we're trying to hear.
If this isn't your palette, is there something on it that can draw someone in? Because we're talking right now, we're talking to RNA, to the Real Nigga Alliance.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
I feel like
so for the
not everybody's yeah for the cufflinks. I feel like the cufflinks are RNA. They do cross over, but
yeah.
The cufflinks may like a bit more commercial.
The cufflinks need to listen to With Me because it's a 3:15, girl. What's it gonna be? I got my hammer in the ride with me.
That's when it turns a bit mad.
No, that's for the cufflinks. I think
Purpose with the sample.
Purpose, Slumdog Millionaire, maybe.
Yeah.
Because
I saw a conversation. Go on, Vans. Let Vans get into it.
The Ride.
Go on, Vans.
The Ride sample.
In the ghost. Look at them.
Probably all right.
That was on the Texas first.
Off the cuff world, wide, baby. So funny. I know my cufflinks. Off the cuff world, wide, baby.
Hopped out the gate to a Bentley. Got me feeling like AJ at Wembley. I got high from the sticks, I'm living stress free. God bless me, guide me, protect me. I'm in the booth so long I just forget sleep. I used to have 10 cats by the Westbury. When I used to share a bedroom with Wesley. Stay at home, remember nanny used to beg me. But from young I've been involved heavily.
Yeah. I used to share a bed with Wesley.
Yeah, this tape is.
Have we been there? Fans, you've been there, sleeping top and tail. Come on, fam. Let him know the truth, man. Yeah. It wasn't always Mary Jeans.
Do your jeans with the rips in.
Come on, man. I'll be honest, my era was True Religion and G-Star. So also knows.
True Religion, yeah.
G-Star.
Man was working at GBK and allegedly G-Star. Doing F at the same time. Allegedly.
G-Star
jeans is like factory jeans. Like, we're working in the factory.
Bro, you can't iron them jeans,
hard denim.
Bro, when I you got to take that shit to dry. I remember first time I watched my G-Star, I was like, yeah, this can't
work. This ain't
for me. This ain't for me. Dry cleaning setting. But yeah, now, Potter Payper. Training Day 3.
Brilliant.
I apologies, I forgot his podcast name, but I saw him having a conversation with Alex Bass.
Right.
He was on there. They're talking about, does he need a commercial song or a commercial hit? How do you lot feel about that?
I think with how the industry is right now, you can exist in a space where you do music that's authentic to you and still have
charted.
The ability to excel.
Yeah.
And he's charted, which is a testament to that.
Mm-hmm.
But
if he wants one, he could do one.
I would like to think that we want artists that we love like that to be as big as possible. Mm-hmm. And for you to, for me and I, in my eyes, to be as big as possible, we need more people to see, to hear and see you.
Mm.
And with that comes a bigger song.
Mm.
So it's almost like, I feel like being selfish doesn't need it. I want it to be, I'll put it this way, I want it, that clean run of 5 years to 10 years where he doesn't have any more jail stints.
So you want an airplane mode?
Maybe. I don't know, but I want something that ensures that, like.
But you see, with airplane mode, it's not 100% on the other side. Do you know what I'm saying?
It's not, but
it's
like
it's a perfect.
It's not, but it is, because now pop music is. It's us, innit? So NSU are going to get played on Radio 1.
That
so
is
he,
true.
He doesn't have to stray too far, like do a type of Pixie Lott or whatever. He could do NSG, he could do AJ Tracy.
But you see, with AJ Tracy,
Dave,
AJ Tracy is.
Radio.
I remove him from that conversation with what I was saying about the perfect
blend.
Do you know what I'm saying? I feel like AJ Tracy is pop with the kind of music that he's doing.
Yeah,
like
he's found
like that. Labrador Grove, with what he did
brilliant.
With what's her face?
Mabel. Yeah, no, Mabel. No, that's West, no. That's W12.
What's the
West 10?
Georgia Smith.
With Georgia Smith.
Oh, Georgia Smith. Okay.
And then
he
recreated that with
Mabel.
West 10.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And the song that I was talking to you about earlier with the sample with Hedy One and Stormzy.
It is different. Yeah.
Like. That
like,
kind of
I hear you, Vans, but I think we are doing ourselves a discredit and a disservice when we label that as over there and almost discredit. Do you know why? Because that comes from us, underground scene.
Yeah.
UKG is our thing. It's just that what happened was it's feel good music and it's vibes, so it can play to everybody.
Mm.
But don't let that, because when we hear pop in two things, I hear like unadulterated pop music, which is like you're over there with the commercial side. And it sounds nothing like us, or something that's so big it becomes just popular
bigger
music.
Than us.
When I hear Labrador Grove,
I
don't like my position as pop, because that for me is authentically us.
It is
from our scene, bruv.
But
because your elders was in the dance, Moe, Champagne Dance, UKG vibes in. Mm. That's our thing.
I'm with you to an extent, but
that's our thing.
Yeah, it is our thing, but the flip isn't necessarily. Authentic.
No.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, Vans, I hear you.
The sample is good, but how they flipped it and packaged it is they've kind of brought it to that side.
Do you know
what George Smith on it, fling Mabel on it, and it sounds like that. Do you know what I'm saying? Like,
but
I still think
we should be clear. For example, like AJ, and they've got like
and
most
this is
stack.
No, this is no plight.
I know.
But just what I'm saying is like, I think we just got. I want us to always make sure we. Claim
still
our
claim
things
it. Agree,
because that thing
of course,
is ours.
Of course.
Before it was that's our thing.
Yeah, and obviously with them doing that, it's not to take away from what we created initially, for us to resample the stuff that we've created. It's
a
wonderful
I still
thing.
Don't think it's...
But I'm just saying, like how it's produced in this modern day, and how it's package to us, it brings me away from it. But that's just me.
I get what you're saying, but I still think even calling something pop isn't.
Isn't
a diss? No,
it's not. I think it's a testament to how people respond. Because my uncle call NSG pop, but
really truth is that's not pop, bruv. No, it is. NSG are getting played on Radio 1 and it's pop.
Because they're lit.
Yeah, but it still makes it a popular sound in the UK.
Hold on. Any nigga with tribal marks on, that ain't pop.
No, but when you think of pop in the UK, yeah, pop artists. Bruv,
Last Giddy. Last Giddy boys.
It's AJ Tracy, it's Mo Stack, it's NSG. You can maybe say Miss Banks. That's not to say that these are.
Banks getting played on Radio 1?
Snack.
I'll be pleasantly surprised. I'm not listening. If she's going to play the Radio 1, hey, Miss Banks.
But that's not. Remember, Rory's father,
hey, Rihanna.
Hey. Yeah, that's not to say that they're still not our artists or still. I think we should embrace even more. So if,
maybe all of it.
And also, it's a testament to show that you don't have to go too far to make a pop song. Mm-hmm. You could just Hollow Mo Stack or AJ Tracy.
To say that Nine's going and doing NSG, looks like him doing pop. Really, truthfully, that's a testament to us. So, like, if within our space, we can have someone that's pop, but still authentic to us, yeah?
Exactly. That's what I mean.
Bro, like, I'm, like, first line, I ain't these other rappers, I supply bricks. I'm like,
Yes. But it's a pop song. Do you know what I mean? He doesn't have to go too far. So, going back to the point. Oh, please. Back to the point of
toxic. We in the building.
You need an RNA drop.
Hey, we in the building. I'm going to get one. I'm going to get hit to an RNA. Real Niggas Alliance.
But yeah, back to the Potter point. If he wants to do a commercial song, he doesn't have to go too far to do one. So it's great. Yeah. It's not like back in the day we had to do a song with
someone playing a guitar.
Liberty X,
you know.
Yeah, I mean,
and the black girl.
It's like when Kanye was doing songs with Damon Albarn from Gorillaz, from Blur and the Gorillaz.
Yeah.
We ain't got to do all of that. Extra up and down, razzle dazzle.
I like that you said that because we've got our. Our real nigga lane. We've got our guys who we consider more poppy.
Yeah, we've got our pop guys.
Like,
we've got
now
everything.
AJ Tracy has found his lane. He's got his thing over there. You will then have like your NSG style, Afro swing, whatever that you coin that term. We have different pockets, like, but it's still from us. So
NSG need their flowers, man.
They do.
So yeah, he doesn't have to go too far if he wants to make a pop song or a commercial song. So I think either way, it'll be a good look. If he does it, he doesn't have to. Mm. But if he wants to do airplane mode, that is not. No one's going to say, oh, airplane mode took away from Nines as a rapper. Like,
no.
Do you know what I'm saying?
No. The video's wavy. Nines doing the shaku in there. We like it.
Yeah. We like it.
All the Northwest niggas on the plane and that, you know.
Come on.
It's calm.
So how do you feel? Because I feel like we've sat with the album, the project, from Potter Payper, Train Day through long enough.
Yeah.
If you go around the room, Sosa, what would you give Training Day 3 out of 10?
Nine.
Cool.
I give it about an 8.
8. Essie?
I'll give it a 9.
A 9?
Yeah. I think it's brilliant. It's so good. It's so good.
Yeah.
I'll give it an 8.
Yeah.
I'll give it an 8. Yeah, no. I think...
That's fair. Yeah. There's a high scores.
It's a very high score.
Yeah, on Crabs in a Bucket, there was a song that I purposely skip.
What song?
The one with all the manem on it.
He tried to recreate something from One Foot Out.
All Stars Part 2.
CSB All Stars. Yeah, All Stars Part 2.
Because the other All Stars has got TDS on there. Yeah, that's the best All Stars.
Yeah. I skip All Stars 2 and I skip.
You don't have to do this because you're like that side of town's princess. They love you. So you don't have to throw your guys under the
bus. I'm not afraid anyone under the bus. But that's the only one I skip. Let me
skip is not bad. But I didn't skip any of Potter Payper stuff. Everything, you know. For me, it's the second half of the project, yeah?
Mm.
It's from, let me go to, before we get off this, yeah, I think it's, let me see if I can find it now. It's from, this is my personally, from, I think from Prevention and Cure.
Okay, so then.
So from Prevention, it goes to Beggars and Choosers, Real Rapper, When I Was Little Purpose, King's Blood. Okay. And I don't, like, I literally, that was when I was in there, tricep dips.
Mine is slumber.
Like, I don't have to have been in the trap, but I need to do these tricep dips.
Gotta do them.
Yeah, you know, so it's important.
Those last few reps, it'll just carry you through.
Bro, I need that horseshoe. Because obviously, I've been doing my research.
I don't know what you're
the tricep's
about.
Two-thirds of the arm. So, niggas be trying to do bicycles. No, tricep, baby. That's going to make the arm look big. Yeah. Have your BM hug holding onto the arm.
No, please.
Allegedly.
Allegedly.
RNA.
Mad.